At the time I'm recording this, I've only been doing astrophotography for a few months, but I've loved space and learning about it for as long as I can remember. It just fascinates me how we coexist with these massive cosmic objects that we can see in our own night sky. The first piece of equipment I'm setting up is a tripod. Now you're going to have a pretty sturdy tripod because it's going to have to hold up anywhere between 5 to 11 pounds worth of equipment depending on what your setup is. The next piece of equipment is the equatorial mount. The one that I use is the Orion Starshoot Compact Astro Tracker with a polar scope. The equatorial mount acts as the brains of the whole rig. It allows the camera to follow the night sky, and it's where you will input the information that tells your DSLR how many photos to take and how long to set the exposure. Next we have the panoramic ball mount. This is where you will attach your camera and move around the mount to a point in the sky depending on what target you want to shoot the night of. Finally, we have the DSLR. The one that I currently use is the Canon Rebel T6i, and although it isn't particularly made for astrophotography, it's a very good camera regardless. I'm also using a 55 to 250mm EFS lens. It's a pretty standard lens, but it produces decent results. So before you start shooting the night sky, there are a few settings you're going to want to set on your camera. First and most importantly, you're going to want to set it to manual and to raw format. Manual is going to allow you to set up all these other settings, which I will explain later on. Raw format will allow you to take pictures and retain every bit of detail from the image without losing any bit of data. Next, we have bulb mode. Now, bulb mode is going to allow you to expose your lens to as many seconds as you want, depending on the image that you're shooting. Most DSLRs will have this scroll wheel up here, which you'll be able to change the amount of seconds you want to expose the lens. Next, we have the f-stop. Now, the f-stop is kind of like the pupil of the camera and allows you to take a certain amount of light through the actual lens. So you're going to want to set it to the lowest it could possibly go to. In my case, it's 5.6, but I would recommend going 4.0 and lower. Next, we have the ISO. The ISO is kind of like the sensor sensitivity to light. So the general rule of thumb is to go between 1600 and 3200 to start and kind of experiment from there. You can go to 800, but I would definitely recommend these two. But you're also going to want to be careful because as you get higher in ISO, you also increase the chance of the graininess and the noise that you get in your image. So once you have all these settings set, you're pretty much ready to go shooting the night sky. Tonight, I'm going to be shooting M42, the Orion Nebula. Now, the Orion Nebula is located in the constellation Orion, just underneath the iconic belt that we see in the sky. If you know where to look, the nebula is actually visible to the naked eye, as it is one of the brightest nebulas that we can see in the night sky. Located roughly about 1,300 light years away, it is one of the closest regions of massive star formation to our own planet. Tonight, forecast right now is looking cloudy, but I think it'll clear up just in time for me to get a few pictures in, so I'm looking forward to it.